Hello my dear friends, welcome back again in the new video. So in this video we will see this generator, which is Perkins engine and Stamford alternator with deep sea controller and all the other accessories we will see now. Okay, so now first of all we will see what is the engine type and what is the engine model, what are the filters and all complete review in this video. So as you see in front of me, this is silent soundproof generator which is 200 kVA. Okay, and now we'll see this, what is the engine brand and family. This is Perkins engine, okay, 1106A70TA, model year 2022 and list number, displacement, all this information is available here. Okay, you can see here. Okay, and here we have our oil filling cap, okay, which is also showing which kind of oil you can use. Okay, so from here you can fill the engine oil. Okay, so after that here we have this pump which is made by Delphi. If you see, the manufacturer is Delphi. Okay, and here we have our solenoid switch. This switch control the activity of this pump. It will supply this pump supply to the engine fuel. Okay, once if this is not working, you will not get the supply of fuel. And here we have our speed actuator. Okay, this is our speed actuator and governor, both are built in here. Okay, so this is about fuel injection pump. And after that here we have oil filter, and on the above we have oil sensor. Okay, and this is oil cooler. Okay, if you see the shape, it's different from other engines. All engines have their own design. So this is the oil cooler. Okay, and here we have dipstick. This dipstick, okay, will help you to check the engine oil. Okay, once you remove it and you will check it like that. Okay, this the upper cut. Okay, it will show you the oil level is full, and the lower cut will show you the lower limit. Okay, in case if you need to order parts, how you can order part, you have to share this number with your supplier, this nameplate, okay, which is located here on the near the oil pan. Okay, this is oil pan. Here all the oil is stored here, and even the oil pump is inside, installed inside. Okay, this is called engine block. This is engine block. Okay, where all the pistons are located inside, and above here this is engine block. Okay, this is engine block. Okay, and here we have our two fuel filters. And what is the part number of the fuel filter, we will see now. This is the fuel filter part number 2656118, two pieces of two fuel filters. Okay, here we have oil filter. I will try to see the part number. Okay, here is the part number 4627133. This is one oil filter, and here we have oil pressure switch also. Okay, this is switch, this is sensor. Here we have our fuel water separator. Okay, fuel water separator. And what is the number of fuel water separator, I will try to find it out if it is showing here, because sometime once we install it will go to other site. Okay, so I don't think so we have this filter number here, but I will share it with you. Okay, don't worry about it. After that here we have some relays, 1, 2, 3. These three are relays, okay, for engine controlling, for fuel system control. Okay, here we have a battery, generator battery, okay, with protection cover. This is negative, this is positive. Okay, this is battery indicator. Okay, once it will show you three kind of indications, as you see here. The green means the battery is good, black means you need to charge your battery, and white means replace the battery. Okay, this is sealed type battery, no need to fill any kind of liquids or acid. Okay, after that here we have air cleaner. Okay, because engine need clean air to operate, so this is air cleaner. Okay, and here we have the main element part number. Okay, so this is the air cleaner, and this is the head of the air cleaner, and this part is called housing, where inside this housing the air filter is fixed. Okay, so after that here we have deep sea controller, which is deep sea 4520 controller, and this is our emergency stop. Okay, and this is key switch to power up the controller. So now we'll see to power up. Okay, as you see, deep sea 4520. So now engine is ready to start. Okay, here we have our breaker box. Okay, this is breaker box, and from the from below you can install the cable. Once you remove this cover from below, you can install the cable easily. These are protective also, IP66, so no water will enter. Okay, you can easily open this okay, and turn on and off the breaker. The breaker is manual. Here we have one thing, this is buzzer, okay, in case of any alarm, this buzzer will be give you signal, okay, the alarm signal, okay. After that here, okay, after that here, if you will see, we have rubber mounting between engine skid base, okay, and between the engine, so all the vibration will be absorbed here, okay guys. And here we have diesel filling point. Once you are filling the diesel, make sure your generator is on off condition, not running, okay. So this is our diesel filling point. And here we have fuel level sensor. This is analog fuel level sensor which will give us fuel level on the screen. So now I will show you what is the fuel level now on the screen. So you have to press scroll down, okay, scroll down, and now you'll see what is the fuel level. So no need to check from base tank, you have to check from here, okay. Now you see, okay, 30% fuel is available, because this is the fuel sign and this is the fuel level. So 30% fuel is available in our generator. So what is next, okay, the same rubber mounting is installed here under the our alternator. This is our main alternator which is producing three phase electrical power, okay. From electrical power, how we are taking this electrical power to output, this is the cable, this is the power cable here, connected in this breaker, and this from this breaker we will get the output, okay. So here we have air cooling fan for alternator, okay, and also coupling area. This is coupling area between engine, here is our engine and this is our alternator. So engine is coupling here with the alternator, okay, and this is our, as you know, MPU, magnetic pickup unit speed sensor, okay. So now I will see what else more here remaining. Here one thing is this is our air breather, okay. This is our air breather, and here we have, in this model we have thermostat here inside, okay, and here is the water supply to the radiator. This is our radiator and this is called radiator cap, okay. And further what we have here on this side, okay, let me go on another side and I will explain you the remaining things, okay. So guys, now I'm on the other side. This is our Perkins alternator, okay, Perkins alternator which is 12 volt, okay, and its part number is mentioned here, okay, the part number is mentioned here, and the wirings are connect here. There is two wire, one for sensing and one for charging cable, okay. Okay, this is our fuel temperature sensor fixed on the block, okay, and also this is heavy duty isolation, as you see, this complete heavy duty isolation, okay. And here we have our fuel connection lines, supply and return of the fuel, okay, and here we have our exhaust, okay. This is the external emergency stop, okay, as you see, this is the external emergency stop, okay. This is the outer part for exhaust, okay. Here it will pass the hot air of the radiator, and above here this is our silencer, okay. Also these are the air louvers, okay, and also we have this skid base, okay. I hope you like this video. Take care, have a nice day.